Hi there, my name is Petula, your host here at All Things Agile. And this month, as we are celebrating the first of the 12 Agile principles, customer satisfaction through value, I decided to select one of the questions from my subscribers that is related to that. And the question is, what is it that I could do to make my teams understand how the client uses the product? So here are some 7 ideas divided in 3 categories for you to try with your teams. So the first thing that you could do is ask your customers directly. Of course, you can always try and rely on marketing research and surveys, but the ideas I'm throwing out here, they are really something that your teams could do autonomously by themselves. The very first one is to ask the customer in social media. Quick shout out there. It's easy and simple. Most people are in social media these days and they go once a day, maybe more, maybe a little less, but it's there, it's accessible. And everybody kind of loves to interact with their brands and their products, and people like to be listened to. The second one is invite the customer to a demo. Now, I do realize that sometimes this one can be a little bit more complicated depending on your business, but I do encourage you to try, and I would say most of the times you can do that. If you're not convinced, stick around to hear about number 7. So invite the customer to come in to your demo and then have really the teams and the customer interact with each other and interact with the product. Then the third one is storytelling. It's really asking the customer to tell you a story on how the product is solving a very specific problem for them. And in here, I give you an example to illustrate. There is this company called HelloFresh, and they make boxed meals that comes with all the ingredients that you need to make a meal and the instructions to prepare that meal. And when they first started, they were listening to people, and what became very clear very easily is that organizing those packages of meal by diet types. So you would have keto, you would have vegetarian. As time went by, they continued to listen to their customers because it's really important. And the story that they were hearing quite often created a completely different type of meal that has nothing to do with diet. And it's called flash meal. They realized there was this group of people that actually needed to have something really quick, something healthy, something delicious, but they didn't have the time to cook. Even 30 minutes was too much for them. So then they invented this type, which is 20 minutes or less. And that's one example for you on how very specific problems can give you an insight on the real value that you are bringing to your customers. So the second category is observing people in action, because there is what people say, but there is what people do. Observing people in action, you can catch what they would really do instinctively, and that's pretty powerful. So the first way of doing that, it's literally observing people using the product. You could go to a store right now if your product is a physical one, and then see how people interact with it, how they touch and what they do. If you have a software product, maybe you want to create a little bit of a space where you actually invite people to come in and use the product in front of you. What is very important here is let them do their thing. Don't ask questions. Don't interrupt them. You let them interact. Once they're done, then feel free to ask all the questions that you might have. Then there is the world of technology to help, and that is number 5, the use of analytics. Yes, there are ethical and legal ways of collecting information that we call analytics, which is decision making and pattern of utilizations by clicks, by movements of mouse, and that is a pretty powerful information to have as well. What I like the most is that because it's technology driven, and when you're creating software products, it's all about technology, is that once you start doing it, it really do little pieces of analytics in little parts of the functionality. And over time, you cover the big piece of your product. So when done right, you end up having this just being part of your normal workflow, the same way you would have review, testing, and etc. A/B testing is something that started with marketing, not with technology. And what the technique presupposes is that you solve one single problem in two alternate ways. And what you do is that you get random selections of your customers, and to each of those selections, you're going to offer one of the alternate ways or versions of your product. And then you just see how the customer respond. The ones that they engage with the most, the one that they respond better to, is the one that you stay. It's the one that is clearly giving more value to your customers. And finally, the number 7, can your team use the product? Can they be customers of the product? And that is super important because great ideas will come from really just using it in the day-to-day, you know, visceral ideas once you are in the moment, living it, using it. I do understand that not all product can be that accessible. Maybe your industry is heavy regulated, maybe there are some compliance issues, but I've been into those companies as well, and I would say that for the most part, you can, even if it's just for a subset of your team that you make the product available, and it could be just for a week, or maybe even just for a day. The whole point is to immerse yourself into the experience as a customer, and then you start collecting everything that you see in there. You're gonna collect pain points, great moments of using the product, and a wish list of improvement. So there you have it. 7 ways to make your team understand how the clients use the product. Hopefully you can take one or two here and start making the team really develop that empathy for the customer, and even start thinking like them when they are developing what is next for the product. We'll stop here for today, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.